Hi, and welcome to Talking Tech. I'm your host, Alejandro Hoyos, and today we're here in Computex 2024, and we're here at the G.Skill booth. And with me, there's Mark. Hi, Mark. How's it going?
Good.
Doing well. What do we have here? We have a lot of stuff that we want to cover, so tell me about this whole thing.
Okay. So right here, we have two systems set up for benchmarks, AI benchmarks. And one is running at DDR5 5200 defaults, and the other one has overclocked memory from us at DDR5 8200. And we are running a AR benchmark to compare the performance of the two. Both are running for CPU, and it actually runs through 19 different models to test for AI performance. And it tests for both training and inference. And so right here, we see on the graph, the blue is actually the combination score for training and inference. And when we compare the two, the performance for the 8000 memory kit system versus the 5200 memory kit system is higher by about 15%. So from here, we can actually see that through memory speed, if you increase it, it has an impact and on AI performance.
This is great. So you're showing that, yeah, that a lot of the AI workloads are heavily dependent on memory performance. So latency and speed are a huge key when it comes to that. And just by overclocking.
That's correct. Yeah.
Yeah, overclocking the DDR RAM, you can see that this amazing performance out of
right.
it.
So if you're training AI, inferencing with AI, on the CPU, memory speed is going to make a big difference.
Right, because when you're doing inference, like the first time you're doing we're doing the first token, you're doing a lot of compute intensive calculations, but then after that, the other tokens are all about memory bandwidth and speed, and as you can see, it's doing great.
That's correct. And on top of that, we're actually using acceleration with Intel 1DNN, the deep neural network acceleration code, in order to help speed things up as well. So this also includes that acceleration part.
Oh, this is awesome. This is great. And can you tell us a little bit more about this little guy over here? What's the story behind it?
So this is the $10,000 USD LN2 cooler. When you're cooling with liquid nitrogen, there's usually a pot sitting on top of the CPU, and there's holes into the pot to increase the surface area to help the heat escape and into the LN2. And what they did here is use AI to generate a design within that pot to increase that surface area. And then because that design isn't capable of CNC manufacturing, so you have to use 3D printing to make this. And so what they did is they used 3D printing using copper metal to 3D print this LN2 cooler. So with that difficulty and with that material for 3D printing, that's what makes this really special and hard to manufacture, and that's what makes it so expensive.
This is pretty impressive, and I can't wait to see when you guys take it for a test run.
That'd be awesome.
All right, so let's go check out some other stuff that we have here in the booth that I assume is pretty amazing.
Sounds good.
Okay, so right now we're gonna take a closer look at something that is completely new, and Mark will let us know what is actually what I'm holding on my hand.
Okay, so this is a CAMM2 module. It's the next generation form factor for small memory modules. And this is something that we've been working on in terms of future technology. And right here on this platform, this is a development platform, a concept motherboard platform that we've built around Intel latest 14th gen. And we are working with Aces on this as well. And we've actually managed to get this running on the motherboard and overclocking it to DDR5 7800 with a low latency of CL36. So this is called a CAMM2 module, and we're hoping to see it sometime in the future, near future.
That's pretty neat. So these were designed specifically, well, mostly in mind for laptops, but now you guys want to say like, hey, let's see how it performs in a desktop environment.
That's right. Well, we got to start from somewhere.
Yeah.
And desktop platforms are really, really nice for overclocking performance. So this is somewhere that we'd like to get started from. And then eventually, once we know what we're dealing with, then we can start developing for laptop platforms as well. So hopefully we'll see overclocked CAMM2 modules in the future as well.
That would be great. And you were telling me that how big were these?
How big? Oh, yeah. These modules right here, what we see is 48 gigabytes per module. Eventually, we're hoping to increase that capacity as we get bigger ICs or better support through the BIOS from the motherboard or the laptops.
Right. And you were also telling me that this one's right here are like the where it makes the contact and you just five screws and you're pretty much go set.
Right, so on a motherboard for CAMM2, this is the contact point. So it works like an Intel LGA socket. you press it down and then you screw it in with a couple of screws and then that fixes it into place. And the advantage of CAMM2 over, for example, the traditional SODIMM modules is that it's got a lower profile and it's a lot more compact than the memory slots for SODIMM. So that's something that hopefully can decrease the thickness for laptops.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, that's something we're looking forward to.
Awesome, man. And I think you also have something else that you want to slightly mention.
That's correct.
Coming up. Yeah, so.
Yeah. So in terms of new technology, as G.Skill is always looking into new technology, for memory modules, we're looking also into CU DIMMs in the future. We're hoping to see more support for that. And we already have a heat spreader design lining up for that series as well. The tentative name right now is called the Trident Z5 CK series. And we're hoping to see that sometime soon for next generation platforms as it becomes supported.
But wait, there's more. Actually, Mark, we just wanted to see, actually learn about this because this is amazing. It has liquid nitrogen, but I want to hear all about it. So let us know what's here.
Okay, so we actually are displaying a whole bunch of creative mod systems. And this is one of the more special ones that focuses also on overclocking. And it uses liquid nitrogen for extreme overclocking. And that's what you see coming out here. That's the liquid nitrogen vapor, or the nitrogen vapor coming out, condensing. And what we're doing is actually passing through the liquid nitrogen from the tanks from behind me into the CPU and then out. And so that's actually cooling the CPU to allow it to overclock. And right now we've got the system running at CPU at 7 gigahertz and the memory at 10,100 DDR5 memory megatransfers per second.
That is great because right now, like, you have this is completely stable at that temperature. And I think we were talking earlier, you were saying like how cold it's inside also helps to cool down a little bit the memory.
That's right.
So that's how you're able to keep all these, you know, high frequencies. It looks amazing. What about those? I see like some extra wires going into there, into the socket. Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
Okay, so liquid nitrogen itself is negative 196 degrees Celsius. So in order to maintain a specific range of temperature, those wires are actually a heater inside the CPU block right there. So what we do is that we pump liquid nitrogen into it, and then if it gets too cold, we'll activate the heaters to get the temperature back up, and then try and maintain a balance to a temperature range that we want to stay at.
Oh, that's amazing. Yeah, so you're like this constant flow of nitrogen, and with that temperature and those heaters, that's how you actually regulate everything overall.
Right. So right now the CPU is being cooled to a negative 100 degrees Celsius, and that's the CPU block. And then in the case itself, right now it's about 24 degrees Celsius. So that is the memory part.
No, this is great. So in there you have Intel Core i9-14900K.
That's correct.
Which is G.Skill. And actually an Asus ROG Gamers motherboard.
That's true.
It's a great collaboration.
Yeah.
All right, Mark. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
See you.